Hello everyone, this is Ibrahim Mukdad from Exit Technologies, and the lecture today is about taming big data, and it's going to be a three-series lecture starting off today. This would be an introductory to taming big data. It's more of a theory than practical stuff. So the presentation would mostly evolve about introducing big data, the term big data, how it evolved, and what really makes big data. So as we go on in this presentation, we will start off with the titles, what makes big data, and then what is big data, the definition, and then what changes are there, all so to say, the history of big data, and how can we tame big data, which is the moral of this presentation. So starting off with what makes big data. You know, obviously big data is a combination of big, the words big, and data, so that makes big data. Big, yeah, we all know what big means, and data, we all know what data means, so we'll pass on that. Now, what causes big data? Now, mainly the causes are two factors, people and technology. Of course, the more people, the more data you'll have. Now, let's ignore technology for a moment and just focus on people. Okay, the more people you have, the more data you'll have, obviously. Birth certifications, tax documentations, etc. This all lots of stuff, this all data is all generated because of people. Now many can argue, okay, the more we had people back then, but we didn't have big data then. What makes it different? Okay, coming down to technology. Now technology can be divided into two factors, hardware and software. By hardware we mean mobile phones. Okay, now each and every one of us has a mobile phone, a device, a computer. You see, these devices make data. And looking back 10 years back, I don't believe that each and every one of us had a mobile phone or had a computer or had a tablet. Now, almost all of these three is owned by each and every one of us. Okay, so, from each of these devices, we do generate data. We make calls, we follow up on ours. Mostly, we all have smartphones, I believe. Anyone without a smartphone here? Anyone? All right, cool. All right. I believe I heard a yes somewhere in the back. Nothing. All right. Okay. All right. Yeah. So, all these kind of devices, the modern devices do generate data, and they are one of the main reasons of more data to the more generated data. Another factor is software. Even I had this conversation with a colleague of mine about compression. It was like, okay, software compression is actually limiting our data because when it's compressed, you really can't do much with it. And the argument was about even the compression generates data in itself. If you compress the file, that's a data generated. Now you'll definitely need to have information about that compressed data. So that's definitely another generated data out of the compressed data. And there is another psychological aspect to it. Now the more compressed data, what people started to feel is that, okay, I have more space, so I am free to generate more data. And that kind of generated more data, you know, in itself, indirectly, sort of. Yeah. So, and in software, you have also multiple software. Say, for example, in an organization, you would want to have, a university, just for a demonstration, or just as an example, universities, they definitely would want to have an admission software, attendance software, and accountant software, etc. So all these different softwares do generate data. So you see, as we are talking now, we're building up data, and so far all that we have mentioned are just the norm. And it's not necessarily that the relation that there are that people or the factors of generating more data are correlated. So sometimes you have little people, but you have technology is one of the main contributors. Let's take, for example, the collider in Geneva. The collider in itself generates on every second gigabytes of data. And you see, this is more contribution from the hardware or the technological side of the technological factor, more or less. Yeah. So, in short, in brief, what makes big data is generally people. And association with people are technology, sometimes not correlated, but the main two factors are people and technology. Now moving on, now what has changed? I mean, anyone can argue. I mean, we had this like years back. I mean, what changed now? Why is it a buzzword? Well, everyone's talking about big data. Why is it like the main deal now? You see, what has changed is that the ideologies of companies actually changed. What people thought they had when they generated data, they thought it was a good sign of doing business. Okay, I have data, customers' information, etc., etc. It didn't mean anything to them except that the business is doing well. As long as I have more data, it means that I'm doing well in the business, I have more customers, etc., you know, the general stuff. And to many companies, they had to neglect many of the data they generate because they don't do much with it. They just thought it's more of a data than anything important. And you know, the another part of what has changed is that legacy hardware, or let me say better technologies, is that hardware and software, better and much more enhanced, optimized hardware is rising. And now companies can actually afford to buy hardware with potential, you know, that can do, that can process heavily, and they can process in a better, efficient way. And what is also is that many technologies or many theories have arisen that enabled the execution over big data or these large amounts of information. And that has made potential progression. So now this reaches me to the definition of big data. Now all this introduction was just to prepare us for the solid definition of big data. Now many, as I said, many define it in numbers, terabytes, petabytes, but I stand to differ against these definitions, because what's petabyte to Google or what's petabyte to Facebook? It's nothing. I mean, they generate this information, or they generate this amount of sizes in like what, a few minutes, maybe a few days. Now you see, I strongly believe that I stand with the definition that goes with, or that goes for, big data is actually troublesome whenever it becomes troublesome to work with. And that's what I believe touches on the exact meaning of big data. You know, the more data you have, and the more it becomes troublesome for you to deal with it, and that's when you have big data. Now, what can you do with big data? Now, you have so much information. What is it to you? I mean, what's so important about it? I mean, what you can think of what's important is that the main or the major components of the data. Say, for example, let's talk in examples, which would explain in a better way. Say, for example, the attendance system in the universities. The attendance system is generally about who signed in and what time. Did they come into the office or they came to the university or whatever, yeah? And now let's keep it in the context of universities. Now, they checked in, say, for example, at 8 a.m. Now, what I've come up with is that most of the organizations, they just use these systems for whatever they were intended for. They don't go beyond it. Like, for example, the attendance system, they only use it to check out who attended, who did not, so that they can issue a payment slip at the end of the month. Now, they don't go beyond this. Say, for example, they do not go at the end of the month, why people did not attend, why are people like taking holidays in this period of time, most in this period of time, or why are they coming late on this precise date, or in this month of the year they are coming later than the other months. You see, there are not much done there. They just, you know, they just use the devices, or they just use the information for whatever purpose they were meant for. That's it. They don't go beyond that. So big data, actually big data enabled is that it's enabled, because what organizations avoid, because people avoided this because generally they could not process this much of information and they did not know how. But with the rise of such term, the big data, new technologies have arose, as I mentioned earlier, new ideologies, new insights. And as a result, people can actually see more, can actually understand more, can actually learn more. And that, in brief, my friends, I hope it made sense. It was just a brief introductory. I had a lot to say in such a short period of time. But I hope it made sense. Hopefully in the next lectures and the next presentations, I will be touching on each and every aspect of those that will be explained in a better way. Yeah. And thank you for your attendance. We will, if you have any questions, I think you do have lots of questions. So I'll leave the room when we go out for coffee. Yeah. Thank you very much. And God bless. Yeah.